Greg Dyson. Welcome to New Mexico in Focus, the Bosque Ecosystem Monitoring Program. It's a 20-year-old program. Students collect data from the Rio Grande, everything from groundwater levels to leaf litter. Can you briefly tell us a little bit, who are these students and who are the scientists who rely upon this data?
Yeah, hi Laura, thanks for having me. The students are from all over the state, actually. I mean, the majority are from Bernalillo County. We do a lot with Albuquerque Public Schools, and we're based at Bosque School, the private school right along the Rio Grande. And we take kindergartners through 12th graders out to the Bosque, and they collect the scientific data, which ranges from the depth of groundwater to litter fall to the precipitation amounts, and all types of agencies and government bodies use the data. It ranges from U.S. Army Corps of Engineers, U.S. Bureau of Reclamation, Fish and Wildlife Service, Bernalillo County, City of Albuquerque, Valencia, Soil and Water Conservation District, the Middle Rio Grande MRGCD, Middle Rio Grande Conservation District. So that's just a partial list, but all types of folks use our data for the management of the Middle Rio Grande.
And it looks like you have funding from a variety of different sources, but the bulk of your funding comes from the U.S. Army Corps of Engineers, and it sounds like that's changing. Can you talk a little bit about what's happening and why that's happening?
Yeah, we've had a long-standing relationship with the U.S. Army Corps of Engineers. They funded them pretty generously over the years. And it's through the, there's lots of acronyms in this business. It's the MRGESCP, the Middle Rio Grande Endangered Species Collaborative Program. And what's happened is that the U.S. Army Corps of Engineers funding for this program has been cut dramatically because their budget has been cut dramatically. So they're making cuts all over the place. And this collaborative program is really feeling it. And we got our funding through that, and through the U.S. Army Corps of Engineers is about 2/3 of our budget. And we're in the last year of that. So with the next federal fiscal year, October 1st, we're looking at a 2/3 cut in our budget.
So what kinds of impacts will that have on students, on the monitoring, on the data that you're able to collect?
Well, we have lots of feelers out for getting funding back from other agencies and government bodies, and are very hopeful that we can make up at least a big part of that. But we're also doing a worst case scenario planning. Right now we have 33 active sites along the Middle Rio Grande, and we would go down to 10 in a worst case scenario. And instead of reaching 10,000 students a year, would be more like at 1,000 or 2,000 at the most. So it's pretty major cut. We're currently not replacing staff to leave. So we're kind of gearing up for a worst case scenario, but also very helpful for the best.
So this is a critical time, the last year, not just for students who were and teachers who were having to deal with the pandemic and all the changes that has wrought across our educational systems, but also the Rio Grande. Climate change, drought, changes to the river and the Bosque. What does this loss mean for lots of different people?
Yeah, I mean, it's the saddest. The saddest impact is with the students who, we're really looking forward to getting back in the field with them come the fall semester. And we would have to cut back dramatically. And the data is, it's sad to lose a year of data for those sites we'd have to drop. Well, we wouldn't drop them. We'd set them aside until our funding came back up. We wouldn't close them permanently. But I think the real impact is with the students who, it's getting out in the field and learning to be a young scientist is a unique opportunity. And we don't merely do field trips. We take students out and we show them how to collect scientifically sound data. And the number of examples of students who go on to say, biology, the UNM biology program. I mean, it's really just exciting to see students kind of think, wow, I can be a scientist.
Yeah, we did a show in 2017 where we went out with students and BEMP staffers, and we had a really great time and really saw that firsthand of the students' excitement. But also I've heard from many scientists and researchers over the years how they use this data. And certainly as the Rio Grande is changing, to have this data set really seems pretty critical. So what will happen if we miss out on monitoring sites, if there's time gaps in some of this monitoring? How does that affect people?
Well, I mean, one of the data sets that I enjoy talking about is depth to groundwater. So everyone's familiar with the cottonwoods along the Bosque. Cottonwoods generally their roots will go down about 3 meters in order to find water. And having that, losing a year of data on what's happening with the groundwater level is really important for us to be able to know what's happening with the cottonwoods in the Bosque. And, you know, these are long-term data sets. So the sky is not falling if we have to set some data sets aside for a year. The continuity, we're actually approaching closer to 25 years of data with a lot of these data sets, and the continuity is one of the things that makes these data sets so special.
Yeah, this seems like some bad timing all around, given the challenges that we face on the Rio Grande. Is there anything that people can do at this point?
Well, I think one of the great things about this whole situation is that reaching out to our partners, we've informed all our partners of our funding situation, and everyone has been so supportive. And we just need that support to turn into actual funding. Of course, anyone can donate to BEMP anytime. I think it's also great to let your elected officials know how much BEMP means to the community. That has the biggest impact, I think, of anything.
All right. Well, Greg Dyson, thank you so much for joining us today. I appreciate it.
Thank you, Laura.